life today. Wisdom shown by my conversation, April the 17th. Growing in wisdom and knowledge. Who is a wise man and endued with knowledge among you? Let him shew out of a good conversation his works with meekness of wisdom. James chapter 3 verse 13. How many sins this consistent conduct would have prevent? How many souls it would turn from crooked paths into paths of righteousness? By a well-ordered life and godly conversation, God's people are to demonstrate the power of the great truths which He has given them. A contrast is drawn between those who think themselves to be wise and those whom God has gifted with wisdom because they will not use their powers to hurt or destroy. A man may speak fair words, but unless his life reveals good works, his wisdom is human. Genuine wisdom is full of gentleness, mercy, and love. The worldly policy which men call wisdom is by God called foolishness. Many in the church have become spiritual bankrupts because they have been satisfied with this wisdom. They have lost the opportunity to obtain knowledge and to use knowledge aright because they have not realized that the efficiency of Christ is essential to make a successful merchant for God, one who can trade wisely on His entrusted goods. They have failed to supply themselves with heavenly merchandise, and the value of their stock in trade has continually decreased. It is not enough to have knowledge. We must have the ability to use knowledge aright. God calls upon us to show a good conversation, free from all roughness and vanity. Speak no words of vanity, no words of harsh command, for they will gender strife. Speak instead words that will give light, knowledge, information, words that will restore and build up. A man shows that he has true wisdom by using the talent of speech to produce music in the souls of those who are trying to do their appointed work and who are in need of encouragement. When the heart is pure, rich treasures of wisdom will flow forth.